I'm on call this weekend as a practicing physician. Every several weeks, I am on call for the weekend and take care of patients that are hospitalized predominantly. And yesterday morning, something struck me. I was standing in the intensive care unit, and you have to keep in mind that here I am, for those that are not in Houston, Texas, I am in the Texas Medical Center, largest and greatest medical system, medical complex in the world. And it is a place where you have nearly everything at your disposal. Everything at your disposal. The best of everything. The best of what American medicine has to offer. And I'm in a room in a patient with very advanced liver disease, and I am surrounded by an assortment of machines, devices, things that are beeping. And I stood back for a second in talking with the family, and I snapped a photograph. You cannot see the patient, you cannot see the family. And it is this black and white photograph. You could see it on Instagram. My handle for Instagram is at Dr. Joe Galati. And the entire field of view is filled with all of this high-tech equipment. Things we are doing to the patient, be it dialysis, respirators, all kinds of nutritional supplements, antibiotics, medications, you name it, we are delivering it to keep this patient alive, trying to get them through to get a liver transplant. That is the ultimate goal. And I looked at this, and I'm part of this. I am part of this technology. I am part of the evolution of care in the 33, 34 years that I've been doing this. But what really, really struck me was knowing the history of this particular patient. And she had a number of chronic medical ailments that could have been taken care of 10 or 15 years ago. If she did not develop diabetes, type 2 diabetes, this would not be happening. If she had eaten better and not gained weight, the diabetes most likely would not have set in, which then caused the kidney failure, which contributed to the liver ailment, which contributed to the liver cancer that she is battling. And so I am not here to scold patients to say, hey, you, if you listened, you would not be in this position. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying that the medical system is very, very good at this kind of high-level care, intensive care. That's why they call it an intensive care unit. But we fail at prevention. We fail at early intervention. Now, nowhere in the hospital do we have an early diagnosis and intervention care unit. Or a unit that is designed for, hey, before you get sick, intensive care unit. No, it is let the disease run its course, and if all the poop hits the fan, we're here to rescue you. Now, I'm, of course, being a little bit of tongue-in-cheek here. I hope you understand that. But to make the point, you all have to take inventory of yourselves. And this is what Your Health First is all about. You take a look and say, what do I have that I can intervene today on so that 5, 10, 15, or 20 years from now, I don't end up in one of these ICUs surrounded by $1 billion worth of technology? Now, the problem is also that a lot of people don't feel bad right now. They're overweight. They have hypertension. They have, let's just say, prediabetes. If you were to stop them on the street and say, hey, Bob, how do you feel? They would probably say, I feel okay. I'm 55 years old. You know, I got aches and pains and I have heartburn when I ate too many tamales. Or when I go upstairs, you know, I got this gout and my toes hurt and whatever. So people are not thinking that these minor things are not normal and that they have to address it now. So that is what I want to leave you with for this opening salvo of Your Health First.